Good morning, North America, or good afternoon. Okay, we tried to get down there into the truckers' protest as media. We had a couple reporters from our stations, one station in New Orleans, another one with us, and they wouldn't, you know, these are long-standing stations. Everybody is media accredited. We had our requisite paperwork, and these Ottawa cops in this Trudeau regime and Watts, crazy, you know, they're trying to deny everybody freedom of press, freedom of speech, you know, go along with their narrative. But they're at CBC and their cronies, and it's almost similar, you know, to the disapproved people that J. Edgar Hoover used to carry around and Nixon used to have this like that. And it's, you know, a show of a tyrannical regime, you know, and here in Canada say tyrannical or something. I don't believe that's not the important issue. How you're pronouncing the important issues that denying freedom of the press. So when we got back to the studio, we made a phone call and, you know, complained about, we're going to play the text of that phone call. And, you know, we recorded, we set the phone, you know, we set the phone next to this microphone right here, and we are recorded so you guys could hear all the trouble and how they react to it. You know, first we were hung up on, secondly, we were, transferred to this person. Nobody's there. They could give a flying F about, you know, could give a hill of beans. They don't give a shit about, excuse my language there, they don't give a shit about you guys hearing the real truth, you know, only... You know, and that's why I feel sorry for, you know, so many rebel reporters and True North reporters that were stopped from going credited. They're journalists, reporters, just like anybody else, and they're manhandled by the RCMP. Reporters were physically blocked by that. You know, these are people from out of the country, you know, they're physically blocked. They don't want any, you know, by the Ottawa police, wouldn't let them go down, you know, threats made, the threat that we're all going to get arrested and everything. It was completely, and this is really wrong in my opinion, because we, you know, give a fair opinion to these police, but this totally ticked us off this morning. So we made, and we want you guys to hear it, so you know. And anyways, we have a reporter on her way down there, and hope to get in without getting arrested. You know, Handy Lee's down there, going to do this, you know, she had her own money for the plane fare. Nobody funded her. She's on her way to Ottawa to do, you know, for all your Andy Lee fans out there. Anyway, so we're going to play this recording, see how they treat the media in Canada. All right, thank you very much.
Quatre chiffres de la personne ou de la section que vous tentez de joindre, composez. To continue in English, press 1 now. Pour poursuivre en français, if you're calling to report a residential or commercial break-and-enter that is not in progress, a missing person, a stolen vehicle, or an assault where no medical attention is required, press 1.
Transferred to Media Relations Department. Okay, we have some Americans here. We're a media group. We're based out of New Orleans and Canada. And we tried to get in there with our media reporters. You know, some of them are Canadian. The other ones are from Detroit, New Orleans. And we tried to get in there, and they stopped us from coming in. You know, what's
okay.
Going Why? No, we didn't come in. We were on foot. We were on foot. They stopped us and wouldn't let us in. We was walking from Gladstone.
You can't prove that you live in the No, but we can prove that we have verified U.S. and Canadian credentials. So, you know, what's the problem? That there's no freedom of press anymore?
Okay, well, sir, you were transferred to the media section, and what did they say?
They didn't say anything. They're not even there. Obviously, they're not answering the phones because they can't answer the question.
Okay, well, the one right now that could help you out with that. You want me to try again?
Well, yeah, but it isn't good because they're not answering their phones. Obviously, you guys don't want pictures taken or video. You know, we're not causing any problem. In fact, we reported that you've been doing a fine, outstanding job down there, you know, and everything. See what the problem is, and these are well-known reporters and everything, too, so.
All right. I will try, see what we can do. Hold on.
All right. Thank you. Tried to call through the city number. Now I'm going to call the councilor directly and see if they're going to answer. And the last message on the media release, that was yesterday, on Friday. It's friggin' Saturday.
Hey, Justin Rogers speaking. How can I help you?
Hi, Brockington.
Hmm?
How are you doing? You're Councilor Brockington?
Well, you're speaking with Roger Leboy from the Committee of Adjustment.
Okay, well, listen. Part of the city, right?
Technically, no.
Okay, well, why are you answering Brockington's line? That's weird. We dialed Brockington's line.
I don't know. You got me at the end of our main line.
Well, I don't know how that happened. Anyways, we're from the media, and we're a Canadian media group and a U.S. media group. We're based out of New Orleans and Detroit, and one of our Canadian reporters tried to get down there, you know, just now, and they went through, and, you know, and then a couple reporters from the U.S. with valid credentials established, you know, stations and everything, they tried to get across with our other Canadian reporter, you know, and we had to report. Why is Mayor Watson and his police force denying freedom?
I have no, my office is a judicial tribunal that deals with land severances.
Okay, I'm not trying to say you're in charge.
No, I'm just telling you, I have no comment on this. Our department would have no comment.
Yeah, but that is really strange. You know, it's above and beyond. You know, why are they so terrified of video, you know, records of what's going on? You know, the police the one U.S. reporter there wouldn't let him through. You know, it's, they must have a list like J. Edgar Hoover, Richard Nixon had, who Trudeau's enemies or something, and, you know, have said good things online and in our reports about Ottawa, you know, some of the measure. You know, like Ottawa for a while was one of the most that didn't, how can I put it, didn't go along with some of the things that Ford or even Trudeau wanted to do. You know, the chief mayor and the city councilors, Rick Shirley was out there. You know, I don't know whether he was just trying to get some more votes or whatever he's doing, but it's funny he didn't show up to the mayor's meeting either, but Brockington did. And they wanted Watson to, how can I say this, to, you know, let somebody else run the other meeting the other day, and Watson refuses. He's like a little tyrant time. You know, so who do I contact with media relations for the city or something? Do something.
I don't know.
Because we got a reporter really good. Her name is Andrea Dysock, and she needs to get down there and get some kind of access at least to go to the thing on Elgin there, you know.
I don't know where to direct. What was her name, sorry?
Her name is VNA.
Oh, what was the name of the reporter?
Oh, Andrea Dysock. It's D-I-A-Z-O-C-K. Yeah, like we called the police station and tried to get some kind of response out of them. They either hung up on us once we found our media, or they transferred us to meetings. And you know, one lady did talk to us shortly, but she just transferred some meetings. And it's weird that they're closed. That they said they left a message from yesterday, Friday afternoon. You know, and you can't contact them at the most important time where the media needs to, show the things happening. Whether it sheds a good or battery light on you, it's just transparency, you know.
I really don't.
Oh, I mean to bug you. There's nobody you can connect me to deal with this. Because this is ridiculous. You know, I think in Canada, I know in the U.S. you have rights, but I think you still have, you know, freedom of press. It's weird in Canada how the government recedes all the other rights that follow it. You know, the rights don't come from God, they come from the crown in Canada. It's a divine rights of kings thing, you know, and that's not right for you, me, or us in Canada. Our rights should be unalienable. And, you know, maybe big election reform or restructuring of the government to reflect that would be a good thing in Canada. Not that...
I don't know if you have contacted media relations already?
Yeah, at the Ottawa Police, yeah.
Oh, I have a number for media relations at Ottawa, City of Ottawa.
Okay, let me write that down. If you give me 1 minute, I'll write that down.
No problem.
Okay.
I had to look this guy. I had no idea.
Okay, thank you so much for trying to help. At least somebody there is trying to help. Okay, so what's the number?
Number I have here, Media Inquiry Relations, 3.
Yep.
580.
240. Okay, so I'm going to get out of the way and see what they got to say, if they can somehow assist with this to get her in there. You know.
I have no idea what their capacity is, but
like I said, it's almost like the police have some kind of list handed down from Trudeau, like a Richard Nixon, you know, hated enemies list or a Hoover list. You know, it's you know, strange. It's, you know, inordinately strange, you know. Anyways, thanks for trying to help, and I'll get with this number right away. Thank you.
All right. So best of luck.
Two.
Thank you. la boîte vocale pour l'indemnisation de l'AVEC. Nos heures de bureau sont du lundi au vendredi de 9h à 17h. Si vous êtes journaliste et que vous essayez de nous joindre durant nos heures de bureau, s'il vous plaît, message ou envoyez un courriel à media avec un S, @ottawa.ca. Si vous êtes un journaliste et que vous essayez de nous joindre en dehors des heures de bureau, incluant les jours fériés, s'il vous plaît, appelez au 613